He is the new founder of Susatinable Food Ventures. Of course, we know him as the founder of Wild Earth Pets. Ryan Bethencourt, thanks for joining me today. So I want to ask you, there's the cellular world as well, cultivated meat. And then, of course, we have our CPG plant-based products. It's still going to be a long time to market for cultivated meat. We'll see if fermentation ends up disrupting them. I wonder what you think about the future of cultivated meat. Are they going to be put to the side because of fermentation? Or do you see them aiding in more blended products? So cultivated fat getting into the plant-based CPG to make a tastier veggie burger. What do you think?
I love that. I love the blended. I actually think that meat's death stroke, so animal agriculture's death stroke, is going to come from cell ag. I think that there are plenty of people who are basically saying, that are saying, oh, that's not real meat, that's fake meat, that's plant-based meat, that's coming out of microbes, it's fermented, it's not real. But when we have real meat without the cow, right, then that changes everything, right? Mm-hmm. And so that is the end of factory farming. That is the end of animal agriculture. Like, I think that's what cell-based meat is going to bring to us. And the first products are coming to market in 2022. So Shiok Meats has basically said in Singapore, because the government in Singapore does not have a legacy meat and dairy industry, that there's no one lobbying to stop these companies coming onto the market. So in 2022, Shiok will launch their shrimp meat and shrimp broth products. That's the beginning. That's the beginning of the end for the meat industry.
This is so exciting, Ryan, because in our lifetime, it's not just for Gen Z. In our lifetime, we are watching one of the world's largest transformations. It's so exciting. And I'll say, as we compliment people, hats off to Singapore. Hats off to the Singaporean government for getting behind so many entrepreneurs. They've been very active in giving grants and subsidies. And Singapore, I hope I have this right, a city state that makes only about 11% of its own food. So they're very dependent on other countries around the world. A horrible place to be if you want to start trading with people, to be subject to other foreign entities deciding on if you get food or not. Obviously not a place you want to be. So they're really trying to get their own food sources. And if you don't have a lot of arable land, this is also true for China, you're going to be looking at things like cellular meat, where you don't need land, you don't need as much water, you're not cutting down trees. All these things go away and you can start making your own food supply.
Yeah, most definitely.